I apologize on behalf of my student, but she couldn't get a visa. So I'm going to talk about the problem that you all have and the fact that deep neural nets need a lot of training data. So let me talk about the case that we're studying. It has to do with nuclei segmentation and histopathology images. This collaboration with the Cancer Institute of New Jersey. And we want to identify masks for every nucleus in an image, and we want to do instance segmentation. And the nuclear features are important indicators, of course, of the presence of severity of the disease. And we care about features like average size, nucleus to cytoplasm ratio, et cetera. So there's a lot of research we've been doing over the years, and we keep doing with them. So the question is, how do you find the nuclei? So, and the motivation is, of course, current state-of-the-art segmentation methods are based on deep learning, and they have achieved much better performance over the past few years. And of course, but the problem is they require large amounts of pixel-level annotation data, and the annotation is not free, obviously, it's very expensive. And domain knowledge, of course, is required. You can just get a student to annotate. It's time-consuming, and for example, 115 minutes on an image of size 900 by 900, the images are big, and 60 hours for 30 images. So can we achieve similar performance using much less annotation effort, for example, weak annotation? So there's been a lot of related work, and some people use image level tags, which creates a little information, scribbles. Not convenient enough, and bounding box are also expensive, not expensive, and very hard. And what we do is points, because they are much easier and they convey enough information. So as you see, you do it in batches, in small batches with respect to image, so you can see how many nuclei there are. So we have a method with using three steps. The first two types of coarse labels. First, we extract two types of coarse labels, Voronoi partition, Voronoi diagram, points and Voronoi edges, and you can get an initial information here, and k-means clustering, morphology opening to create clusters, and then you use that as input to initial training a unit-like structure with a cross entropy loss. And then the fine-tuning. Something else that you should also be aware of, I come from Toronto for many years, like with Hinton when I took the first course, is the problem with neural nets is they are very good, but they are sometimes not very accurate. So traditional methods, you should never forget, are good. So if you use CRF now afterwards to refine your traditional methods, they are very good. So combination of neural nets with methods like CRF, for example, can do a lot better. And using the CRF loss. So in all the experiments, we find that we do better with this kind of combinations of methods. And we have two data sets, lung cancer data sets, and multi-organ data sets with different cancers. And based on the various indices we can discuss at the poster, we do better. And here's some results. So you can see the original image, the true mask, Voronoi labels, cluster, and of course, both labels. So of course, they do better. So, in conclusion, we have proposed a new weekly supervised nuclei segmentation method using only points annotation. We generate the Voronoi labels and cluster labels from the point label, took advantage of the dense CRF loss to refine the trained model. So the proposed method has comparable performance as fully supervised methods, but requires much less annotation effort, which is what the biologists work with want. So basically allows to analyze large amounts of data. So thank you, and come to the poster, please. Thank you.